Unit 4, halfway through level 1, we're adding the 4th string, so expanding the range by 3 more notes. And they're accidentals. And for the right hand, this is going to mean lots of thumb practice, the P stroke. In our default right hand position over the strings, we have IMA on the trebles, right? So P naturally falls on the 4th string. And in general, it's going to be responsible not just for the 4th string, but all 3 bass strings. But, you know, as with most right hand principles, there are going to be exceptions to that basic rule. Rather than memorizing strict rules about the guitar technique, it's always better to assess any given situation for efficiency and practicality. And that's a common theme throughout the course. So, same thing here for P. In some cases, you'll be using the P on the treble strings, and sometimes IMA on the bass strings. So for additional practice, you can play the pieces in this unit using all MIs, no P strokes. Then you can run through the entire piece using P strokes for extra thumb practice. These are still single line melodies, so it's a great practice opportunity both ways. We'll be ramping up the tempo, syncopations, and other rhythmic challenges with some African, Balkan, and Irish folk tunes in this unit. It's always a good idea to start practicing slowly, you know, especially for faster pieces, establishing the correct rhythmic structure first, then gradually increasing your tempo over a few practice sessions, just to make sure you're playing the rhythm accurately. We'll be doing a lot more practice on the technical essentials like the hammer-ons, and also introduce a special PI alternation, which is another exception to the standard MI sequence, right? It might feel awkward at first, but this fingering using P and I on the same string will be an important asset to your right hand technique. Enjoy your practice. I'll see you in the next unit.